time of the year when it seems each and every night almost all the games have postseason implications. This one is no exception. In Florida, 3-0 the prior night Thursday, only to fall to the seemingly non-playoff bound Panthers the very next night. A save by Jones, a loose puck, and he'll cover it ahead of Zach Parise here tonight, including a shutout for Jones last time these teams played here in Minnesota back in November. A 4-0 San Jose win. Marcus Sorensen, a shot knocked down by Dubnyk. The rebound available. It took a San Jose bounce off the glass. And now Timo Meier working his way across the Wild blue line. Checked by Jared Spurgeon, wraps it around. Dubnyk looking for the puck. It's underneath the big man. And he'll cover up as Meier tries to extend his goal scoring streak. Tomas Hertl fighting his way to the net. And a save by Dubnyk. Gus Nyquist, to San Jose add at the trade deadline. Here's Burns off the net looking for Nyquist, and Dubnyk with a splendid stop off Hertl.
Goes off of Eriksson X, and then a good effort there by Hertl to pick up that loose chain. You see him battle with Ryan Suter in front.
Kevin Fiala, the trade deadline add from Nashville. And a shot by Brodin. It went off the post behind Jones. And he's able to get on top of it.
This one here by Parise on the shot by Brodin. Tips that puck down. Awfully difficult for a goaltender to react in a situation like that.
A shot block trickles through to the side of the net. Foligno unable to corral it as Justin Braun sends it up ice. Now Brendan Dillon for Melker. Carlson, who pumps one to the net. A juicy rebound off Dubnyk. On the entry pass, comes back out. Stahl will dish across for Spurgeon. And Zucker with speed around Burns. And he can't get the shot away. Influenced at the last moment by big number 88.
Watch a stick of Brent Burns. As he gets beat, he's able to turn around the body of Zucker and then lift the stick of Zucker, avoiding the hands. Tremendous defensive play there by Burns. Fortunate for San Jose, they got away with it.
That wasn't the case two nights ago. As Fair turns and fires, and Jones dives out to block that. Martin Jones was victimized on a similar play against the St. Louis Blues on a goal by Patrick Maroon.
I have no clue how Fair didn't score there. I'm watching his reaction as he goes to the bench.
San Jose coming into the day with the number 4 power play in the league. Zucker fails to clear, and now Burns with it as they spread out to Couture. And a glove save by Devin Dubnyk.
Logan Couture gets his puck through. Dubnyk does a good job of fighting through the screen of Joe Pavelski.
Punt there again. Sharks get a line change. And now on the ice, it's Meier. Timo Meier one-hands it to the net. Dubnyk with the short side covered. Steps wide. Now to the net. The save by Jones off Brodin. Great power move there by the defenseman. Fiala keeps it alive. Now Brodin back at the line. Hands it off. Shot saved by Jones. Rebound as he tries to find it amidst all that humanity in the goal crease. Still no whistle. And pucks not in the grasp of Jones. And finally it is. It's an area that they need to improve upon. Talking to backup netminder Alex Stalock today after the morning practice, he said, we've got to be better. Here's Suter with a good chance. And Jones with the save as Ryan Suter cuts in and got a good look to start this Minnesota power play. Suter with 3 power play goals so far this season. And a good play there at the blue line by Radim Shimmick for the Sharks to break it up. Now the Wild again. Comes up top. The shot saved by Jones. Eric Stahl had a grade A look there. Sharks American Hockey League franchise, the San Jose Barracuda, who also, as the Sharks do, play out of SAP Center in San Jose. Shimmick shot. And Dubnyk with the save. Fought off, but not cleared out. Braun from the point off the net, gobbled up by Brodin. Now Sorensen in front. This is Dillon. He'll load up and fire, knocked down by Dubnyk again. Timo Meier with a double poster there to give the Sharks a tremendous chance to get the first goal of this one. Now the Wild comeback as Foligno wanted Brown in front. The one exception might be Luke Cunnan, who is banged up but would probably slot back into the lineup based on his body of work so far. But the Sharks have much more waiting in the wings, and they score! Vlasic shot deflects in, and the first goal of the game goes to San Jose.
No chance for Devan Dubnyk on this one, as Goudreau was just simply going by, goes off of him, and a fortuitous bounce for the San Jose Sharks.
Nyquist and Braun against Donato and Eriksson Ek. Puck out, Wild with it. A chance for Eriksson Ek, and Jones will cover it up. The final half minute of the second period and the final few seconds of this second Wild power play. Donato with some room, works his way in, shoots wide off the board. Jones bats it away from danger with 23 or more goals. And by contrast, the Wild have just one player like that, Zach Parise. Here's a chance for Minnesota, Kevin Fiala, and he couldn't pull the trigger.
Couldn't settle this puck down. Watch, he's in a prime scoring area there, and he just simply chopped that puck up and allowed Pavelski to get back in time and get that puck out of harm's way.
Knocks down the puck, gets it flat to the net. Eriksson Ek reaching out, couldn't make contact in time. Zucker beaten by Hurdle. Two on one down low. Tomas Hurdle scores! Tomas Hurdle, who hit the 30-goal mark for the first time in his career earlier this week, gets the 2-0 goal.
Good patience here by Hurdle to outwait Devan Dubnyk, and he's able to slip it past the pad.
You got to be ready for it. Fiala. Now a shot by Donato, saved by Jones, who continues to shine when called upon for the Sharks. This will stay in. Now turn back out. The chance for Couture, and he's got a break. In alone, and a hook from behind on Boteto. And a penalty shot for Logan Couture.
Couture is able to settle this puck down, stay onside, and you see the hook right there by Boteto on the hands.
One for two career on penalty shots. Couture against Dubnyk. Scores! Logan Couture, and the Sharks with a third goal.
A good job by Couture to look maybe low blocker and then fire it through the five hole ever so quickly. And I think this discussion may be about whether or not Couture was offside on that initial penalty shot. I mean, that's the only thing that I can think about. I wondered if he had possession or not.
The play is not challengeable, therefore the goal stands.
Vlasic, who's been in on the scoring tonight with an assist, moves it up ice. Right back is Donato. Here's Ryan Donato, and he goes too high with the wrist shot.
And it's showing again here tonight as they just seem to have trouble connecting and appear to be a bit disjointed.
Perhaps it started with the move of Niederreiter before that, as Jones will cover that up. Wide for Parise, knocked down the elevated pass, but not to the net. Fiala gives it. Now a chance for Suter on the one-timer under the glove of Jones, and then up out of play.
Trying to find Suter coming down the back door, and I think Jones just gets a little piece of it.
Next up for the Wild, a date on Thursday against the team right in front of them in the standings. The Dallas Stars will be here. Burns to the net, saved by Dubnyk.
It'll be interesting to see who he starts tomorrow as well, if Jones goes back-to-back or if he goes to Arundel.
This one's over. Martin Jones with a 24-save shutout, his third this season and second consecutive here at XL Energy Center against the Wild.